We are excited to present you Sigmund, our new bundle. It comes with 49 module designs and 17 complete page layouts. And just to give you an impression, here's an example page. This is a homepage layout that you get with this bundle. And as you can see, it has this bright and professional modern design. But of course, go to bundle homepage and have a check at other modules and layouts. And if you like Sigmund, you can download it. And if you have already downloaded it, let me show you how you can install and activate it. To install the Sigmund, first thing you want to do is to install the assistant plugin, and then you want to import all Sigmund layouts. So first go to plugins and then add new. Click upload plugin and then browse button. Navigate to files you downloaded, and here you want to select Sigmund assistant plugin zip file. Click open and then install now button. Now the plugin has been installed and you want to click activate plugin button to activate the plugin. And also you need to add your API key. So click here link to add your API key and API email. You want to add them here, and after that make sure to click save changes. Now that you have the assistant plugin installed, let me give you a quick overview what you can see on the plugin settings page. First tab here is get started, and here is the button that will take you to a knowledge base page, and that's the page where we add some tutorials and helpful articles about the Sigmund. Then there's some brief instructions on making changes to Sigmund and customization, and also there's the button to open master CSS file. It's basically the CSS file that will help you to customize the plugin, but there'll be more, I'll be talking more about this master CSS file in the next tutorial, so make sure to watch that as well. The next tab is system status and troubleshooting tab, and here's the table with all your server settings, and ideally you should have the status OK for each of these configuration options. Otherwise, if your actual value is not matching the recommended value, you're going to see warning sign next to that option, and if you see that, you should contact your hosting support and ask them to match the value of that configuration option to the recommended value if possible. Then there's the tab for API key that we've seen already, and also there's a help tab if you need help and you can't find anything useful in our knowledge base. You can also submit support requests and we will respond immediately. There are two ways to add modules and layouts to your website. First one is to go to Divi library, and here click import and export button, select import and then choose file. Navigate to files you downloaded again, and this time select master Divi JSON file. Click open and then import. And this is going to import all the modules and layouts into the Divi library, but also it is going to add all the images to your media library. You might don't want to have all these images imported, and you perhaps don't need all these modules and layouts into your library. Perhaps you don't want to use all of them. So let's see the other method, the other way to do this, and then you can decide what better suits you. If you go to our website and then go to Divi plugins, go to Divi then on demand plugin page, and this is the plugin that helps you more easily and quickly find the layout you're exactly looking for and easily add it to the page and or save it to the library in just a few clicks. And I'm going to show you now how that works. You can download this plugin for free. Once you install the plugin, go to settings and then Divi then on demand dashboard. And here on your left you can see the filters options that you can use to quickly find the module or layout that you're looking for. You can use the search box to do that, or you can toggle any of these options. And on your right, all the filter and modules and layouts will appear. So for example, if we toggle only Sigmund collection, only the Sigmund modules and layouts will pop up, and all you have to do to save any of these layouts is to click the save button. And also you can quickly preview the layout, and that's another advantage using Divi Then on Demand plugin. But also you can click view button, and that will take you to an actual page with this layout on that page. And as I said, you can just click the save button, and in a moment it is going to be saved to Divi library. Then go to your page, click load layout button for example, and then click your saved layouts. And now you'll be able to select the layout you just saved to the library. Just click it and it will automatically be loaded onto the page. Now just publish and let's quickly preview just to make sure that this works and that our page is here. There we go. So that's it. If you want to find out more about how to customize the Sigmund, watch our next tutorial. That's it for this one. So thanks for watching.